The working group consists of some of the most heroic canines in the world. It includes dogs originally bred for very specific work, such as guarding, search and rescue from water or from snow, and even in the case of the Doberman Pinscher, to help collect taxes. Some are exceptionally versatile. The Boxer, for example, was bred for guarding and for tracking, and now just for looking fantastic.
So you're picking on the Boxer there?
I love boxers. Well, we've had some stunning breeds today. And Frank and Wayne, welcome to the studio. Big day. Are you getting excited?
Well, it's been a fantastic day around the breed rings today. Some fantastic dogs, wonderful judging. We've had a great time.
Well, let's start off with the Rottweiler, shall we?
Well, we've seen our number one dog of the year, the Bichon Frise, tumble on Friday and went second. Our number two dog for the year was the Rottweiler, and he looked in great form but went second in his class, beaten by a young dog who's become a champion on the day. So he's a very nice dog. And then that dog was beaten for best of breed by a bitch. So it's the bitch we'll see in the group judging tonight.
Good stuff. They're lovely dogs, actually, aren't they, Rottweilers?
Yeah. I personally love them. Right, Newfoundland. Pretty exciting stuff going on in there, and what magnificent looking.
Well, we had one of the world authorities on the breed, Manly Massa from Italy, judging today. The ringside was packed. We've all looked forward to seeing him judge, and we had a fantastic winner. A dog from America who lives in Italy, who's won best of breed, and a bitch from Belgium, a black bitch. Now, the thing about the dog who's won, he's a Lancia, which means he's a black and white. Quite a rarity for the black and whites to beat the blacks and the browns. He is a truly magnificent dog, and I'm looking forward to seeing him.
If you spotted him in a field from a distance, you might think it was a Frisian cow.
Yes, or several of them.
The markings are very important in that colour, yes.
Yes, which normally with most breeds, the markings shouldn't have too much impact, but Dalmatians and those, it's important. Now, I went round and met some of the dogs today, because I think it's very important to do that. And I met a very romantically bred giant schnauzer called Philippe, who was conceived in Paris.
Yes, Philippe Olivier. And again, international. That seems to be the theme this year as Crufts grows. And this is a dog who rarely represents what's going on scientifically, because we're showing all of these beautiful dogs that have gone abroad, come back, and then the gene pool widens, and we have better dogs, healthier dogs, and Philippe Olivier is certainly a tip for the group winner tonight. He's magnificent, and was the winner last year.
Absolutely. Well, let's hear from his owner, Kevin Cullen.
You're never confident, because you just don't know. You don't know who's going to be coming along. There's always young dogs coming up, so he always does the business in the ring. So we just hope, never know.
And there was a newcomer as well, the Russian Black Terrier, a fabulous looking thing, big.
Well, this is the first time they've had breed classes at Crufts. They're a breed who are growing in popularity. The breed club has done a great job in looking after the new owners interested in the breed. They're at least 31 inches at the shoulder and huge bone. Claire, we went to feel a bone on the front legs of one of these. It was like a horse, wasn't it?
It was. It was like a very young, sort of small horse, but that's how thick the bone is.
Yes, but it's not a new breed, is it?
Oh, no, they've been in Russia a long time. They've got some schnauzer in their background, and they take quite a lot of... They're strong dogs, they need sensible owners, and quite a lot of grooming to them.
Yes, sensible owners with strong arms.
Now, there's a Doberman called Boris, Wayne, that has what we call form. This is a serious form dog.
Yes, a beautiful dog. And this dog really defeated some real good ones today, because there was a very strong entry in males and in females, and he had to go beat the bitch for best of breed as well. So he's a super dog in great condition, too. And I think he's got a real shot tonight. It's a great breed.
He was best of breed here last year. He's also got the advantage of a very good handler.
Look how excited she was as well to win that.
So she won't be fazed by the big ring occasion later this evening.
Well, she's going to get her chance. And let's hear from Sue Mycroft.
The group here, to get in the group here last year, but to do it a second time is phenomenal. So now I know I've got that opportunity again. So to have it 2 years running is great.
So the breed judging is complete. And let's have a look at the very best of the working dogs here at Crufts this year.
If you change your mind, take a chance, I'm the first in line. Honey, I'm still free, take a chance on me. If you need me, let me know, gonna be around. If you got no place to go when you're feeling down, if you're all alone.
Take a chance on me. We can go dancing.
Let's hope the judge isn't changing her mind. We'll see Brenda Banbury in a moment picking her shortlist. But first, what about the shortlist for you guys? Frank?
Well, I'm torn between the Giant Schnauzer and the Landseer Newfoundland. But to be honest, my heart's been won by the Landseer Newfoundland for today.
When you watch that thing,
wonderful,
just
wonderful
look
dog.
Look at that.
Fantastic mover for the size of dog. Wonderful dog.
The markings almost make more of it somehow.
They do.
Wait.
Well, I think it's the Giant Schnauzer. I think he's a gorgeous dog, Philippe Olivier. Frank likes a little bit, too. I love this dog, and I think we saw him last year win the group, and to come back and win it twice in a row would be extraordinary, a great feat for a really good dog who deserves that kind of record.
And he's got two advantages. First of all, Kevin Cullen is a great handler, and Kevin's mother-in-law sends him a bottle of holy water from Ireland to spray on the dog every time he competes.
So
that's a big advantage.
Exactly. Didn't they test for that? Richard,
is a test.
What caught your eye?
Bernie's Mountain Dog, I think it's French bitch, isn't it?
Wonderful, it's marvellous. Great breed judging, a wonderful lineup of bitches. I love this bitch, she's a great mover as well.
Good choice.
Well, there you go. Yeah, well, I like to think so.
Well, Frank and I went round the rings and we watched the boxer judging because that's obviously what I wanted to see. There was a very good bitch came up against this quite young dog. This was the graduate winner. He's 2.5 years old, is he?
2.5, yes.
He's called Look At Me and he's just got a bit of that
good
about him. Exactly.
Right,
Look At Me. And that's what all these dogs are going to be saying to the judge, Brenda Banbury. Let's hear the shortlist with Jessica.
Brenda taking centre stage there. She's had Pyrenees in the past and she's got to sort this lot out. 22 breeds in the working group. She's pulling out the Alaskan Malamute there. The Bouvier des Flandres. The Young Boxer. Claire will be pleased about that. And we've also got the Doberman. Coming out into this final lineup, that's four breeds. Philippe Olivier, the Giant Schnauzer, has been pulled out into the final group. Now let's see if Frank's Landseer is coming out. Brenda moving down the line there towards him. Yes, she is going to pull him out. How could you leave that dog behind? The Newfoundland. He's looking magnificent. And the Siberian Husky coming out too. So it looks like that's our final lineup. Here they are, the last seven in the working group for 2005.
A warm round of applause.
The Malamute, the Bouvier, Boxer, Doberman, Giant Schnauzer. Here we have the Alaskan Malamute.
The judge was Mr. David.
This one is Cheo Blue Thunder. He's 3.5 years old, belongs to Sue Ellis, and is handled very capably in the ring by Jeff Corrish.
This is a wonderful dog. Great strength, and you have to remember these dogs are meant to pull things, so when you're judging them you have to look for the athletic part. You have to look for that muscle tone and balance and structure, because if you're pulling something you have to have a front end that matches the hind end, and this dog does. The other important element, thinking back to the derivation of why the breed was built, was the coat. It has to be able to protect them in the weather. The tail curled a bit over the back so that when they curl up to go to sleep they can keep their nose warm.
This dog really looks like he's on form, putting in a beautiful performance tonight.
And the tail also have to stay out of the way of all the gear, the working gear behind them.
No working gear tonight. Just a dog pacing out absolutely beautifully. Now, we saw Helen Irving, didn't we? The judge of the Bouvier des Flandres in our preview program. She will be thrilled that her dogs made it into the final cut. This one came from the Netherlands for Eric Zwoflink and René Wolgoff. And he's called Gies Santos from the Dogs Farm. He's 3.5 years old.
And he's come from Holland, and the breed is very strong there. And the Dogs Farm is a very strong kennel that produced many famous champions. This is a cattle dog, bred originally in Belgium, and it's known for its strong skull, short muzzle, and its harsh matte coat. So thick, that coat. sloping top line and free active movement. This is a very good dog. I'm sure our breed judges should be very pleased with this performance here.
Oh, I know she will. She'll be thrilled. She said the judging appointment was for her late husband, so a good mark of that he's got into the final cut. She'll be thrilled. The boxer, this is a young one. This is Newlaith Look At Me. Just 2.5 years old is George. He belongs to Pauline Taylor, handled in the ring by Vicky Van Beck. This is his first challenge certificate today, so quite an achievement.
And it probably won't be his last. This is a magnificent dog. He's got a gorgeous headpiece, that definitely short muzzle, very unique to this breed. As you can see, the natural ears, gorgeous arch to his neck, beautiful muscle and form. And the thing that this breed is known for is its great character. They were bred to be a guard dog originally, but they make wonderful family pets and are great with children. This is a fawn in white. They also come in brindle in white, with the white feet and the deep, dark fawn, short, sleek coat. Gorgeous head.
400 in competition today. The top winning bitch in the breed, Brindle, won the bitches, but both judges agreed that the dog had the nod for the day, so he's come forward. Great achievement.
And a thrill for such a young one, too. The Doberman. Champion Talaker, Vaisan's boy at Supita. Boris, he's 3 years old, belongs to Peter Maycroft and Dave Geldard, and is handled by Sue Mycroft.
Yes, he's a very good dog. He was best of breed here last year. To come back a second year and win such a strong breed as the Doberman is a great achievement. Beautiful wedge-shaped head, almond-shaped dark eyes, neat ears. And we see very typically that slightly sloping top line, the high-set tail, beautiful angulation on this dog. He's got good sloping shoulders, which give him that reach in front and good drive behind. He's in the most beautiful, gleaming condition.
This breed competition was so thick today. The bitch was gorgeous that he had to beat for best of breed, and the other dogs in this open dog class were just as strong. A glorious representation of this breed.
I did try to get near the ring, but you couldn't, could you?
Hard pushed.
The giant schnauzer, champion Jaffrak Philippe Olivier. Philippe is 4 years old now. He has the most fantastic show record. Kevin and Sandy Cullen own him, of course, Kevin handling in the ring.
I distinctly remember a couple of years ago, Frank Kane taking me by the arm, as he always does, and dragging me all the way over to Hall 4 to see this dog for the first time. And he just does take your breath away. The one thing that hits you about this dog is balance. Balance of foreface, balance to back skull. And to have a dog of this size and balance also have the same and correct coat, the good harsh coat that's weather protected and protecting him from the elements and the barbed wire and the other work they do. Magnificent. Showing beautifully here tonight on form, keeping that hard top line and keeping very sound on his feet. Breed type soundness, showmanship, all in one package. Truly a great dog.
And consistency. He was top dog all breeds 2003, won the group last year, and here he is again. Now, Frank's going to go weak at the knees. The Newfoundland, American champion, three-pond Council Cup Bogard, Bogey. He belongs to Patty McDowell and is handled in the ring tonight by Oresti Polini and was bred by Lynn Anderson. Comes from America, of course.
He's bred in America, living in Italy. He won the Euro Dog Show last year. So he's got a list of achievements to him. And, you know, sometimes you come across dogs which are good, you come across dogs which are great, have that something extra about them. Now, today when I saw him, I thought, this is a truly great dog. I was bowled over by him. Marvellous ringside today to see this, and a wonderful bitch from Belgium won. But he had the nod, and I think he's a super dog.
He's having a great time in the ring, too. Enthusiasm.
To get a dog of that substance moving so freely. Beautiful, clear markings on the dog. He's just quite breathtaking.
Well, that's Frank's tip, I reckon. This is champion Forstall's Zalinik. He's an 8-year-old dog, so he's come from veteran, most probably, called Cub. He belongs to Sally Leach, Cheryl Leach, Brian Coops, and Ali Skilton, handled by Ali in the ring.
It's a great tribute. One of the older dogs of these breeds continue to look and do well. And it's especially important in these working dogs, a dog that is bred to pull a sled. Again, a lighter because it's different terrain, different kind of snow. It's not going through this thick, heavy stuff. It's going for speed and pulling the sled at a great continuous speed. So you're looking for a dog that can maintain that gait when they're working and when they're in the show ring. Beautiful representation here of a Siberian Husky that's very, very typical for this part of the world.
And the Leeches have certainly always worked all their dogs, so they're always in the most fantastic condition. Super, so that's our final lineup. Now Brenda Banbury has to choose our penultimate group winner.
As the boards are brought out.
The boards are out. Brenda looking down the lineup there. She's heading towards the centre of the line. She's going to, for the second year running. Well done, the giant schnauzer champion Jaffrak Philippe Olivier takes the working group at Crufts 2005 for Kevin and Sandy Cullen. What a fantastic win for this dog. Group two, who's going to take group two? A roar of applause for the Doberman, champion Taleka Weissensboy at Supita for Peter Mycroft, handled by Sue in the ring. Group three, it's the Landseer Newfoundland, American champion three-pong Council Cup Bogart. Frank will be thrilled about that. Who's going to take group four? Oh, Helen Irving will be delighted. It's the Bouvier de Flandre taking group four. But we have our penultimate winner.
And a warm round of applause.
And Philippe the